Chika, beloved. Yeah, we are coming to the end of another week. Wow. It just went by so fast because the Lord is speaking mysteries to us. The mystery of imitating Him and the path to it that Jesus modeled for us. He gave Himself to God as an offering and as a sacrifice. Excuse me, beloved. And that is where true love begins, that you will give yourself to God. Yesterday, on this devotional, we looked at Romans 12. The Lord said, get on the altar yourself, offer your own body, your own lusts, your own anger, your own pride, your own issues. He said, lay them on the altar. He says, that is your reasonable service. This is the only thing that makes sense. And He says, you should do it and do it holily. Because except it is holy, God will not accept it. He says, holy and acceptable unto God. Many times we are offering a service and I will wonder, is this person aware that it is God they're giving this to? Because the way they're offering it, God will not accept it. You don't give God leftovers. You give Him cream de la cream. Here I go talking about that, oh, once you mention money, people run away. But beloved, you don't pay your bills first before you give to God. You don't wait to catch up on your tithes while you take care of other things. You are just, what is it, just fulfilling the rule. You will not see the honor and the favor. The Bible says, honor the Lord with your substance and with the first fruits of your increase. The first. It says, so shall your barns be filled with plenty. It says, your presses will bust out with new wine. I don't drink wine and I don't need that, but wow, let my spirit bust forth with new wine. Let my spirit be filled with the glory of God. That's what matters the most, when God is honored. It's a fragrance like no other. Look at the same mystery in 1 John chapter 5. The Bible says, whosoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. And everyone that loveth Him that begat, loveth Him also that is begotten of Him. He says, if you love the Lord our God that has brought all of us into His family, then you will also love all the other people that He brought along with you. By this, watch this, we know that we love the children of God. So how do we know we love God's children? Many believers don't love God's children. They hate church people. I know church people are difficult, but they are still God's people. And if you don't love them, I promise you, your stuff will not work. He says, this is how we know that we love the children of God. When we love God and keep His commandments. You see the same reality again. The same mystery. Wow. That loving you is not really loving you. That loving you is first loving God and doing what God is saying. And that love then comes through God, through my heart. That's why Paul says, the love of Christ constraineth us. Even though we may not want to do this in and of ourselves, but there is a love working in us, compelling us to minister to you, compelling us to reach out to you. Wow. Then, just go to any church, then you see clearly who loves God and who doesn't. Just watch how they treat people. You know they haven't kept His commandments. They haven't loved God. Many times people get angry over every little thing, and then you think is the issue at hand that is the problem. It's because in their closet, they're not obeying God. In their personal life, they're rebelling against God. Then they lack the grace to relate to other people. And they talk down the children of God. They cut them down. Beloved, I know God's people are difficult, but don't join that crew that speak against God's people. You're going to have a problem with God. You're going to mess up your prosperity. You're going to live in frustration. Verse 3 says, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. Beloved, remember, we are learning to imitate God. We are learning to do it Jesus' way. And he gave himself to God by obeying the commandment to die for us, by obeying the commandment to surrender himself to God. That's the only thing you can do. That's the only way you can get there. There's no other way. We will keep talking about this for some weeks. And I pray that God will open your eyes as he's opening mine. And that we will use these things daily in our interaction with other people. And you will be clear that we are following our Heavenly Father into the realms of glory and victory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Don't forget to go to church this Sunday. Come and worship with us if you're in the Atlanta area. We are in Union City. God will bless you. The glory is in the house. See you next week. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Welcome to
resurrection.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.